again, dear friends. I hope you are all well, and we'll enjoy the spring weather when the rain stops and the weather finally gets here, but I'm hopeful. March programming, as always, was robust with our Light in the Midst of Darkness week, commemorating resistance and resilience during the Holocaust. Thanks so much to Arts Emanu-El Committee for their hard work in putting it all together. It was amazing. We had another Shabbat Ma'agal, and of course, there was Purim. And when I tell you everyone got involved, I can't even count the amount of volunteer hours, people baking the homentashen, people helping with the Mishloach Manot fundraiser. By the way, $24,000 was raised in that fundraiser, so kol hakavod to all of you. You helped pack the bags. You helped deliver over 500 Mishloach Manot and bring that spirit of Purim to so many people. And then there was the Brotherhood with their wine sale and their beer tasting. And there was the religious school and the young families who did the Purim Carnival. And that was so much fun. And then there were all the people who read the Megillah. And of course, the Purim Spiel. So it's just amazing. Thanks to all of you who came out, who left, who sang, who supported the 30 cast members of all ages who made Purim truly joyous. And if you haven't seen it, my understanding is that it will eventually make its way to a computer near you. I think it's going to be posted on the TEPROV website or on YouTube. Stay tuned. The fun of March continued with the first Temple Emanu-El improv group, which started on March 27th. And from what I hear, the eclectic group who joined together to have laughs, and I'm hoping that they'll perform at the next year's talent show, I heard that they had a blast. In April, well, you know what's coming. On April 2nd and April 9th, there are Seder planning workshops. And on the weekend of April 5th to the 7th, Temple Emanu-El is having their first family Shabbaton retreat at Camp Ramah. It should be great fun. Over 70 are signed up to have a meaningful and fun camp experience. And thanks to the staff that are going to help facilitate that. Our Chazamir choir will be performing once again in New York the same weekend. So the officers of Temple Emanu-El are leading Shabbat services on the 6th with the congregation, and thanks in advance to Peter Salson, who will be delivering the Dvar Torah. We once again had to cancel Shabbat Chai, that was scheduled for April 12th. And I want to explain what's going on. The temple has needed to work in the kitchen and get some staff certified in food safety per new licensure requirements from the state. We're working very diligently and hope to be up and running for hot food again, hopefully by the end of April. So stay tuned. It's all good stuff. And the kitchen has never looked so clean, what can I tell you? On April 13th, we will celebrate with the Hochman family as Hannah becomes a bat mitzvah. And the following day, we will join with the sisterhood as they do an antiques roadshow at the same time that the U.S. Wires are having a chocolate seder, so the synagogue will be buzzing. Passover begins on the night of April 22nd, and while we're not going to have a big kiddush for the days of Yontovin, we are planning a really nice kiddush for Saturday, April 27th, where the sanctuary and the Minyan Chadash communities are going to come together in prayer. Friends, if you haven't seen the form in the kol, there is something called Pesach with Friends. If you have room at your table and are willing to host a Temple Emanu-El member, please let Sharon know. And if you're someone who is looking for a Seder to go to, please also contact Sharon. We're going to try and hook up as many people who have space with as many people as who need it, because we want to make sure everyone enjoys Pesach together. And now, a word from our sponsors. This spring, at Temple Emanu-El, will launch a new way to support the temple, and we're hoping that you will join in with us. We want to ensure the temple's long-term future. By including Temple Emanu-El in your will or your estate planning or retirement plan, you'll be able to help Temple Emanu-El Providence thrive for the many years to come. Details will be coming. This month, we are highlighting another staff member, as we do every month, and this month it's Sharon Sock. Though truthfully, her birthday is not until the beginning of next month, so don't start wishing her happy birthday quite yet. Sharon has worked as the membership director, the graphic designer, and assisted so much with fundraising for our capital campaign. She's an artistic genius and will often have craft nights at her home, enabling those who are artistically challenged to create challah covers for our new member gift bags. She's a talented singer, and she's the first face of Temple Emanu-El to new members. Sharon. I'm going to get verklempt because she's taping this. Sharon, thank you so much for all you do and for all your talents. This is ridiculous. Wait a second. Thank you so much for all you do and for all the talents that you so generously share with us. As you sit around your Seder table singing, Dayenu, Ilu, Ilu, Hotianu, Hotianu, Mimitrayim, Hotianu, Mimitrayim, Dayenu. Take a moment to think about what you're really grateful for, what you would call your Dayenu moments, what your Dayenu song would sound like. For me, if I only had Temple Emanu-El as a place to pray, it would be enough, but I also have it as a place to meet friends, to eat, to laugh, to be joyous in my Judaism. If Temple Emanu-El only supported one minyan, it would be enough, but we have soulful Shabbat, we have minyan chadash, we have early Shabbat morning, and Shabbat biyachad, dayenu. If Temple Emanu-El only had one Friday night service option, it would be enough. But we have Shabbat Chai and Shabbat Baal Gal, soulful pop-up Kabbalat Shabbat services, Minyan Chadash Friday night get-together, Dayenu. If Temple Emanu-El only had a lively Megillah reading, it would be enough. But we had the Purim Carnival and the wine sale, Mishloach Manot and a Purim Spiel, Dayenu. When you think about Temple Emanu-El, think about your Dayenu moments. And have a wonderful, meaningful, kosher Pesach. Till next time.